What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and you just saw a quick unboxing on Lenovo's ThinkStation P630 Ultra. So what comes inside the box? You have your setup guide, you have your safety guide, you get a keyboard, a USB mouse, you get yourself a Wi-Fi antenna, you got your heavy gauge power cable, and then you have your power adapter, which is 300 watts. Now, I'm actually going to take the power cable and the power adapter and hook up the cable. Let's put this stuff to the side. And then last but not least, we have the beautiful ThinkStation P630 Ultra from Lenovo, weighing around 6.4 pounds. Thickness is around 3.44 inches with a height of 7.5 inches if you have it standing up, with a width of 8.5 inches. Now for ports and features, if we are looking at it on the front-hand side, you have your power button, you have your hard disk drive indicator, you have your audio combo jack, you have one 3.2 USB ports, and then you have two 3.2 Type-C Thunderbolt ports. Now on the back side, let's take a look at the back side. On the back side, you have your Wi-Fi antenna connector, one 2.5 gigabit Ethernet port, and then one gigabit Ethernet port. You have three display ports. You have your RTX graphics card, depending on which model you get. On this review unit, I actually have the RTX A2000. You have four 3.2 USB ports and your power in port. Now, typically on my reviews, I take a PC or a laptop and I hook up a monitor or keyboard and mouse in the power supply and I power it on so you guys could take a look at that stuff. But on the P630 Ultra, I had the worst time with it. This unit was giving me so many problems with a lot of things. So I'm not going to bother with hooking up a monitor and turning on. I do have some B-roll, which I'm going to slap right now, me powering it on and showing you the boot time. The machine, in theory, is super fast. It all depends on how you get it spec'd out. I mean, overall, with the hardware that this machine has, it's great. Now, the speaker is actually located at it right here, at the top right here. And the loudness that I got on the speakers when the machine was working with me with no problem, the highest I got was around 95.2 decibels. Now, for performance, this review unit came with a 12th gen Intel Core i9-12900 processor, which basically consists of one socket, 16 cores, and 24 logical processors. Came with 32 gigs of memory, 1 terabyte of a solid state drive. It came with two GPUs. The first GPU is basically the Intel Ultra Graphics 770. And it also came with an NVIDIA RTX A2000 with 12 gigs. Now, you are able to customize the P630 Ultra with up to a A5000 graphics card. I think the lowest one is a T400. So the price range on this one will depend on what type of graphics card and memory that you get. Now, I did mention that I had a lot of problems with this review unit, and that's the reason why I'm not plugging anything up and powering on. And I typically show you like live the specs and all that stuff. When I was installing all the programs on the machine, it was super fast. I was super excited. I thought this machine was gonna like fly. This machine is built to handle like AutoCAD 3D rendering, using like 3D Max and Maya and Premiere and all that good stuff, and using like Blender, AI, configuration. This machine is capable of handling all that, but for some reason, I had issues with the MPEG encoder, issues running After Effects. Like when I was creating composites, I wasn't able to see anything. It was just a horrible, horrible, horrible time trying to get this machine up and running. I did not want to spend a lot of time, troubleshooting it and getting it up and running for you guys for the review. So I'm just telling you how, my experience with it was really bad. The heating, I got around 78 to 85 degrees. I think it will go a little higher depending on what you're doing. If you like rendering like 4K files or rendering stuff out like 3D Max stuff or AI, Blender stuff, I think the graphics card is going to overheat itself. You do hear some sound when the GPU is being used. I did hear some sound on this machine during that time. For gaming, I tried to play Street Fighter on this guy, and again, I had some issues with it. It kept on saying something about it needs DirectX 10.0 or higher, but it has Windows 11 installed, and Windows 11 by default comes with DirectX 12.0. So again, another problem. I don't feel like it was the machine. I felt like it was the operating system that was giving me a lot of problems. And I was so close to actually wiping it clean and just installing Windows 10 to see how it would work. But I said, you know what? I don't want to spend too much time on that. Now, because of the two graphics cards, you are able to go inside advanced settings and then configure the hybrid to discrete. And that's another thing. I was not able to boot into advanced settings to configure that. I really wanted to configure the RTX A2000 to be discrete so I could take advantage of Premiere and as well as After Effects to only utilize that GPU. Now for external monitors, you have so many ports. I mean, you have three display ports and the graphics card itself has an additional 4 mini display ports. So you can have a total of 7 monitors hooked up into this machine. Now the price range for this guy, retail price starting is around $1,200 and it could go up to $5,000. It all depends on how you get it configured. I think the $5,000 point is if you get basically the highest end GPU, and that is the RTX A5000, and you max out the memory. Are you able to upgrade this device? Yes, it is super easy to upgrade this device. At the back, there is a latch that you're able to just basically remove the casing, and you're able to see everything, able to see the hard drive, able to see the memory and the graphics card, and upgrade everything in one shot. Now, the size is pretty decent. I like these type of machines. In theory, this machine with the hardware and the specification should be a beast, but for me, I just had so many problems getting it up and running to do a full review or a full honest review for you guys. And that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoy this somewhat review on Lenovo's ThinkStation P630 Ultra, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.